What's up, everyone, and welcome back to Movie Rays. In today's video, we're going to take a look at how the characters in Riverdale actually look like in the classic Archie comics. Let's just start off by saying that there is a lot of things the show has changed about the original characters. Riverdale is one of Netflix's most watched shows to this day, but we do wonder how well-received the show would be if the cast was a little closer to their comics counterparts. Our biggest problem with the cast is that the original story is about a group of 15-year-olds and not 18-year-olds, as the characters in the Riverdale show seem to be. Some parts are also a bit over-sexualized for a group of 15-year-olds, but hey, it's still a great show. With that said, let's start comparing each character to their comics counterparts. First up on the list, we have Archie's dad, Fred Andrews. I'm pretty sure that Fred Andrews is the character that looks the least like his comic counterpart. In the comics, Fred Andrews is overweight and bald, something we can't see in the show. Luke Perry still crushed his performance in Riverdale, and therefore it's extremely unfortunate that he passed away from a stroke, meaning that he won't be a part of Riverdale Season 4. From the least accurate comic interpretation to the most accurate, we have Veronica Lodge. Actress Camila Mendes was actually not planning on auditioning for Veronica at all, but when she found out that the producers were making the character Latina, she decided to go for it. We are happy that she did, because there is nothing except for Veronica's originally black and purple lips that doesn't match her comic counterpart. Next up, we have Jughead Jones. Jughead Jones has black hair, a Pinocchio nose, and of course, his iconic beanie. In the show, we can find everything except for the Pinocchio nose, but let's just say that it's probably better that way. Did you know that Cole Sprouse actually has blonde hair, but in order to match the comics, he dyed his hair into dark brown? We can confidently say that Cole Sprouse is even better than the original. Moving on to everyone's favorite athlete, Archie Andrews. Archie is definitely the show's teen heartthrob, and we feel like he's the kind of guy girls could fight over. KJ Apa, the actor for Archie, has Archie's iconic red hair and thick black eyebrows. But there are still some things that don't match up with the comics. For example, the original Archie had freckles, and this is something we can't see in the show. What do you think? Would KJ Apa look good with some freckles, or would that be a bit too much? Tell us in the comments down below. Riverdale's blonde mastermind, Betty Cooper, is played by none other than Lili Reinhart, and we can say that they couldn't have found a better actor to play Betty. Lili Reinhart naturally has brown hair, but for the role as Betty, she had to dye her hair blonde in order to match the comics. With her blonde hair, she sports Betty's iconic ponytail, which is a big character trademark for Betty. The only thing that doesn't match the comics is the bangs that Betty is usually depicted with. Other than that, it's a perfect match. Next up, we have the character with the craziest family, Cheryl Blossom. From her brother dating her cousin to her dad selling drugs, not to mention her mother, Madelaine Petsch, it received a hard role to play, to say the least. A fun fact is that Cheryl Blossom actually was banned from the Archie comics for a while for being too sexy. Madelaine has a very similar look to the comic version of Cheryl, with her natural red hair and similar body shape. The two things that don't match is Cheryl's originally green eyes with Madelaine's brown. We also found that in the comics, Cheryl usually had purple lipstick instead of the iconic red lipstick. Moving on to Veronica's sinister father, Hiram Lodge. Mark Consuelos is a man with good physique and a very sinister look to him. It doesn't take much for him to look like an evil mastermind. This is pretty far off from his comic counterpart, since in the comics he's displayed as much older, with both white hair and a white mustache. Along with the white hair, he also wears a pair of glasses, and he certainly looks like a businessman, but he isn't that scary with the comic look. Jumping to Cheryl Blossom's love interest, Toni Topaz. In the comics, Toni, just like Cheryl, has an iconic color, which is purple. She rocks everything from purple clothes to purple hair and lipstick. I think it would be a cool feature to add in the show, since that would make Cheryl's color red and Toni's purple. If that's not couple goals, I don't know what is. It was obvious that the directors would have to do some changes to the characters in order to make the show work, and I have to say that most changes were good. With that said, if you liked the video, make sure to subscribe and leave a like. Also, don't forget to comment your thoughts on the show down below.